shirt, man.
What'd you say?
You're Finding Nemo shirt.
Come on. How'd that go for you?
No one has a sense of humor in here.
No one has a sense of humor in here. Yes, everybody but you is wrong.
Come on, dude, it's glittery.
It's glittery. Yeah, it is.
Taylor Swift should be wearing that.
It is glittery. What is... Are you okay? Sir, are you familiar with what I do?
Absolutely. You're gonna try to roast me, but...
No, I'm not. I'm gonna throw you the fuck out if you don't shut up. It's a tough one, because I don't like kicking out someone before the show starts. But if this is you now, what the fuck are you gonna be like with two beers? Like, this is... Sir, okay, I understand that you think you're hilarious. I also understand that you're wrong. And whoever... What?
You don't have to find your emotional shirt out?
Do you? What I do know is that you are not the show, and this is really fucking weird of you. Like, especially when, like, I was about to throw you out, and I was like, no, I'm not going to, and then you're like, I'll make it happen. So, what I'm saying is, okay, have you ever been to a play before?
Absolutely.
You have? You've been to theater?
Yeah.
Yeah, when you go to theater,
yeah.
Do you participate?
No.
No? Yeah, do you notice the stage?
This is what you're known for.
Right? Yeah. He's gone.
Sorry.
He's gone. Sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt your plan to kidnap the governor, but I... tell you that it's my fault.
Yep.
He's going to say, I don't understand. I just did what I was supposed to do, not realizing that 200 other people weren't doing that thing. I understand. This is a ridiculous shirt. I am well aware. But Finding Nemo? Of all the references to be like, Green Paisley, that must be Finding Nemo. I would like to know what the fuck connect. Like, no, if he was like, hey, I think Steve's doing cocaine, like, that would have been a good assumption. It's not true, the shirt would make more sense. He was like, man, Steve must have gotten robbed and could only shop in Miami. Like, also, could have made sense. That's how you fucking roast someone, you dummy. Anyway. A good show is the crowd.
If anybody has a problem with my shirt, shut the fuck up.
Hanging out with a buddy, and he was like, you look exhausted. Let me get you a cup of coffee. I said, I don't like the taste. He said, have you ever tried a flavored latte? I said, I know what those words mean. And he got me one. And let me tell you this, Paw, that's the best fucking thing I've ever had. Holy shit. Flavored lattes are so good. They're so good. They're an alarm that tastes like a milkshake. How's that possible? So I got real into lattes. So much so that 3 weeks later, I had a latte machine at home. Which is how I know I can never try cocaine. Because 2 months later, I'd be Pablo Escobar, and that's not the life I want. I don't know how to take care of a hippo. And I know, it's confusing. You're like, but you don't do cocaine, but you are wearing that shirt? Yes, it's true. It is true. We just showed up in the same stores.
Seriously, what's with the shirt?
What's with the shirt? Sir, do you know what fashion is? It's a shirt that turns people's heads. I mean, some of you couldn't even fucking concentrate on the show.
What are you wearing? Let's compare.
What are you wearing?
Oh, you stood up. Wait, come forward, sir.
Step into the light here.
Let's
let's do a little fashion show. You got a runway there?
Yeah. On the runway.
Oh.
Eligible bachelor number one. Someone needs to teach him how to dress.
This is, no, you know what? I totally get it. I understand that, you know, some of us aren't as into farmers only as you are. I get it. Some people get jacked and some people get lumberjacked. So I don't know. Hey, when you iron that, how do you know when the shirt ends and the tablecloth begins?
How do you make fun of that shirt and not how much it looks exactly?
It's a term called peacocking, which basically means like standing out a bit. And for a very long time, I wouldn't dress like that. For a very long time, I would wear like black t-shirt, blue jeans, because I was like, I want to try to blend in as much as possible. I don't want to stand out. And then I remembered, I'm a 6'4 redhead, and that shit has sales. Why did I come to Papa? Because it is on the way home. Jason's doing this amazing thing and you know, building up this art center, and I'm trying to do the same thing in Pittsburgh, and we were talking about it, and I was like, hey, you know, I'd love to come check out the space that you're building and hopefully, you know, recommend it to a bunch more comics, and that was the plan for tonight, to see if, like, if I enjoyed myself here, I was going to go back home and tell a whole bunch of other comics to come out to Pop Up, and then one guy was like, must not change the town. I feel like it was a weird, like a version of Footloose that was happening. No, I think something like this is great. I think it's really cool that we're able to do this. So why not come to Buffalo?
There's only so many sports bars a town needs, you know? You gotta get variety in here.
Yeah. I feel like that should be the slogan for Papa, is just like, it's on the way. You gotta pee somewhere. You can also go poo poo. Pee poo poo.
Papa. We are available if you work at the Tourism Council. Good moments in bad days, if that, you know, if that's possible. Like, if you're having a bad day, you try to concentrate on the good stuff. I mean, think about it, this, like, the mind automatically concentrates on the bad stuff and amplifies it. I mean, you are 200 fucking amazing people, and I'm still being like, Finding Nemo, you fucking little prick. Nemo wasn't green at all. What the fuck are you talking about? You don't even know shit. Seen an ocean. Fuck you.